The ability to recognize geologic features helps one to assess how the material at the site may be distributed. These features include geologic structures, floodplains and river deposits, glacial deposits, arid land forms, and coastal processes. The following list identifies some of the most common and important geological features that can affect geotechnical engineering projects. Faults are fractures in a rock mass that has experienced movement. They can lead to differences in elevation at the ground surface, differential erosion, contrasting visual appearance, and weaker bearing capacity of the fault material compared to the parent rock. Outcrops show up at the ground surface when the rock layers are inclined. The area on the ground surface associated with an outcrop depends on the thickness of the layer and its dip or angle with the horizontal. Escarpments are asymmetric hills formed when an outcrop is eroded unevenly or when the edge of rock layers is not flat. A cliff is an extreme case of an escarpment. Faults are created when rock layers are curved or bent by earth crust movement. Synclines are concave features, valleys, whereas anticlines are convex features, hills. Faults are best seen on escarpments. Inliers and outliers are the result of erosion. Older rocks are typically below younger rocks. When an anticline erodes, the old rock appears at the surface between two zones of younger rocks, inlier. When a syncline erodes, it can lead to the reverse situation, outlier. Karst is the underground landscape created when limestone is eroded or dissolved by groundwater. This process leads to holes in the limestone, called sinkholes, which can range from 1 meter to more than 100 meters in size, and may become apparent while drilling during the site investigation. Subsidence refers to settlement of the ground surface over large areas, in the order of square kilometers. Subsidence can be caused by pumping water out of the ground for irrigation or drinking purposes, pumping oil, digging large tunnels and mines, the presence of sinkholes, melting of the permafrost, and wetting of certain soils that collapse in the presence of water, called collapsible soils. Meander migration occurs because rivers are dynamic features that change their contours by lateral erosion, particularly around bends or meanders. The soil forming the bank on the outside of the meander is eroded and is sent to the inside of the meander by the helical current of the river as it takes the meander turn. The inside of the meander then forms a sandbar. Floodplain deposits occur when rivers experience flooding and the water spills over from the main channel into the floodplain. The main channel is a high-energy deposition environment, and only coarse-grained soils heavy enough not to be transported away are found there. In contrast, floodplains are a low-energy deposition environment where fine-grained soils are typically found. Floodplains and main channels can end up being buried or abandoned as the river migrates laterally and vertically. Abandoned floodplains are called river terraces. Alluvium and alluvial fans are soil deposits transported to the bottom of a steep slope by the erosion of a river flowing down that steep slope. Colluvial fans are deposits that form by gravity at the bottom of steep slopes when the slope fails. Dunes are wind-blown sediments that accumulate over time to form a hill. Permafrost is a zone of soil that remains frozen year-round.